Hello, today I'm going to talk about information retrieval and music. I'm Devashish Nyati. I'm a graduate student at San Jose State University and I'm going to tell Shazam's story. Can you recognize this song? Okay, I can. Let's see if Shazam can recognize this song. Whoa, that was fast. So those who don't know what Shazam is an application that is used to identify music, which song is it, and it can identify music from the beginning, from middle, from anywhere. So it's not necessary that the song should start from the beginning. Okay, so Shazam is based on a research paper written by Avery Lee Chun Wang. The title of the paper is An Industrial Strength Audio Search Algorithm, the link to which is in the description. What this paper talks is that they have deployed a flexible audio search engine. The algorithm is noise and distortion resistant, so you can identify music which is having noise and distortion. It is computationally efficient and massively scalable. The algorithm uses a combinatorially hashed time frequency constellation analysis, and it is very fast. Now let's see how the basic architecture of Shazam looks like. So their database has the original songs and the hashes of the original songs. So they are storing the hashed value of the original songs, and when a new recording is coming, they are hashing it and they are comparing the two hashes. If they are same, they are showing the result. Now how it works, there are three steps to it. First is fingerprinting the audio. Second is making time invariant hashes, and third is querying for matches. This is the spectrogram of a music song, and it has frequency on y-axis and time on x-axis. So fingerprinting from this spectrogram will look something like the right hand side figure. It has all the key points of frequency with time, and the algorithm can identify which song it is, and it will generate a unique fingerprint for each recording. Now the next thing is making time invariant hashes. So this is used because you can search for a song from between also. It is not necessary that you are starting from the beginning. So what it does is it calculates the frequency at one key point, it calculates the frequency at the next key point, and it calculates the time difference between those two points. So it's basically calculating the notes at which two points are, and it is calculating the delta time between the notes, and it is hashing it. The third part is querying for matches. So the real power of this search is that instead of looking if a single note exists in a song, we are looking if two notes separated from delta time seconds exist in a song. So you can see from this figure how this algorithm works. So in the center image, you can see the query which we are giving it to Shazam, and on the left figure you can see the actual database, and it after some matches it is going to give the song is being matched. So this is how Shazam works, and yep, thank you.